Can Shiba Inu go up over 1,000% to reach back at its old all-time high? Find out in this video as I'll give you my price prediction for Shiba Inu in 2023. Let's actually first begin by scrolling slightly in on the weekly time frame. The main thing that I'm looking at right now is this orange EMA. This is the 20 exponential moving average, and it is known as the medium-term average price right here for the price of Shiba Inu. Right through this area, we're looking at the slope of the EMA. If we have a positively sloping EMA, it means that we only want to be looking for longs to the upside. If we have a declining EMA, we only want to be looking for shorts to the downside, as we want to be trading in the direction of the trend, as this is the higher probability play. If we did have this uptrending market, we'd only want to be taking longs in the market, as it is a higher probability of the trend continuing to that upside direction. So when we now look at Shiba Inu, what direction is this EMA actually going? It is definitely going in this downwards direction. So right now, we have not got any signals to actually be buying Shiba Inu in this current price point. What I would want to be seeing is this price to begin ticking to the upside, actually begin surpassing prices in this area, then coming back down, using this 20 EMA as a support, then pushing even higher above these prices for another time. So this is the type of price action I really would want to be looking for. This break above this high, then we come back, retest it as a potential support, and then look for even higher pushes. We would need to see this type of price action before I'm getting super comfortable in Shiba Inu. Right now, since we have this declining EMA, the high probability plays is to actually get short every time we come back to the average price. But through here, we did actually get a decently strong break through the average price, and we really haven't had that other than this bar here that literally closed one above and exactly straight. The next bar went directly down. Through here, we got one close, two close, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven bars in a row that actually closed above this medium-term average price, which then signals to me that potentially the bear market is beginning to fade, and we're starting to use this area down here as a support level. As you look back here, basically when Shiba Inu launched back in 2021, we're basically retesting the bottom, complete bottom of these prices, and you can actually see we nearly made a complete bottom in this current 2023 prices, comparing back to the 2021 prices. Also, what that tells me, since we're basically staying in this trading range price action, that this top end of this cycle through here could potentially be acting as a bit of a resistance level, because we're using this bottom end as a potential trading range, also looking for potentially losing that top end as the trading range. So again, I have not got any buy signals right now in Shiba Inu because of this downtrending exponential moving average. The next tool that I use is the Fibonacci retracement tool. I actually go to this all-time high and drag it down to this current low, and we get price populating in this area. We get this 0.382, 0.5, and this 618 level. Now, I've actually come over to the daily time frame to scroll into the chart so we can see if any of these confluence levels actually line up with these Fibonacci retracement levels. The first thing that really jumps out to me is in this here area here, we were actually in a symmetrical triangle. Price was converging between these two lines, and we were making a form of a symmetrical triangle. Now, you would also know that once we get this symmetrical triangle, we would have this apex area, which is right where these two converging lines meet. In the last third of the triangle, if we were to break it up into thirds, this is the highest probability area that the triangle is going to break. You would either expect a really strong breakup to the upside or a really strong breakout to the downside. But once we also get that breakout to the downside or to the upside, what's a very common pattern is to come back and retest this apex level in the market. And look, that's exactly what we've done. We've got this triangle in here. We've got the apex point right here where we got that breakout. Price decided to now break to the downside in this area. But look what happened. Price then came back, retested this area as a resistance level. Initially, it was acting as a support and resistance level. Then we got that breakdown. It then acts as a resistance level in this area. And then we got really strong breaks to the downside. We basically went down 85 to 90% from this level as soon as we touched the apex of the triangle. But that was the high probability play, since after a symmetrical triangle and we do get that breakout, then we get the apex retest. That is a perfect level to actually re-enter in the market in the direction of the breakout. Since we got a downwards breakout in this area, we want to be looking for a downward selling pressure in this area. And even if you just got a really quick trade from this high to this bottom, that's over 46%. So basically making 50% in the market. Now, the reason this is significant is because price is very common to come back into this area. We've had a really strong support in this area. It then flipped to a resistance level, and a lot of people are actually going to come back into the market and expect these prices to definitely hold as a bit of a resistance level. The best part about this is now that we have a confluence zone, we have a confluence zone at this 618 level where a lot of people in the market are also looking to get short back in this 618 level. What that actually means is from the bottom of this move, from this bottom move down here all the way to here, that's a retracement of 61% back to the old all-time high. This would be a move 100% from this bottom all the way to the top. But once we get to this blue line through here, that means we've retraced this overall drop basically 62%. And lining up with that support to resistance flip, lining up with that triangle in the market, that now tells me that we definitely have a little bit of confluence here at this 618 level. So as I was talking about previously, really, we would want to see a strong break out of this area. The reason we'd need a break into this area is because that would then give enough time for the 20 EMA to trend to the upside. And I only trade in the direction of the weekly EMA. If the weekly EMA is to the downside, I'm only looking for the downside movement. And I don't expect Shiba Inu to really drop any more than its current price. If we actually calculate exactly from its high all the way down, that's over a 93% drop. So basically, if we are going to drop anymore, you're basically saying that Shiba is going to go to zero, is basically going negative, which means it's going to be worth nothing anymore. The coin will not be actually available. I do expect there at least to be a decent amount of resistance in this level, especially also because we've had spikes in these areas all through here. We've also got this basically old all-time high. We've also got the 618 level in that area. So overall, like I was saying, we need to see a strong breakout. We need to get this trending EMA to the upside. Otherwise, I won't be longing. But even if we look from an area through up here, if we were to get a break above this channel and then look for a percentage move to the upside, that's still a double or a triple. Looking to the top side, it would be close to somewhere around 500%. The next tool that I like to use is the trend-based Fibonacci extension tool, where you actually go to the all-time low, you drag it up to the all-time high, then drag it down to this current low in the market. Now, with this circulating supply of Shiba Inu, it's basically trillions and trillions of Shiba Inu is available in the market. And that's why it is very hard for it to come up to this current price point. If we actually look at Shiba Inu and we look at its current market cap, it's got a $4.5 billion market cap. So if we're saying that price is going to come back to this all-time high, back in this level, it means that we're going to go up 1,400%. And that would mean that we're also going to go up 15 times its current market cap, which would put it at around a $60 billion market cap. Now, obviously, there's been a lot of inflation with Shiba Inu. There's been a lot of coins that are basically being printed. There's definitely a different amount of coins that are available from back in this high, because once we're up in this high in 2021, that would have mean Shiba Inu was at that $60 billion market cap. That would basically put it right in the top five cryptocurrencies. It would actually absolutely be crushing a lot of these other cryptocurrencies. So overall, if we're looking at even reaching the old all-time high, that would be over 1,000% away. You're basically saying, can price actually do that type of movement? And we're looking at this trend-based Fibonacci extension. If we go from our current price and actually drag it up, that's close to 2,000% to the upside. It's basically saying that Shiba Inu is going to go to a $90 billion, nearly $100 billion market cap. Now, the entire crypto market would need to go absolutely insane for Shiba Inu, especially to actually do those types of movements, because it's definitely a massive meme coin. It's not an overall something that you use as a platform to sell NFTs or it has some actual massive use case behind it. It's definitely an interesting coin, and a lot of these meme coins have a lot of potential, but overall this isn't a that exciting coin for me, especially looking at the EMA, especially looking back in this area, how much of a wick we've had to the upside. In basically 2 weeks, 3 weeks, we went from this price all the way up. We went up over 300%. So really, we'd need to be seeing some really crazy movement on Shiba Inu. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash the like button, make sure to tap that subscribe button, and leave a comment on which coin you'd like me to do next.